Hey everyone, Cheryl from Teaching 2 and 3 Year Olds. For April, our main theme is going to be spring. And we're gonna try something out a little differently this month, where we're going to have one theme all the way through the month, but each week or every 2 weeks, we will add something else as well. So this week starts our spring theme, week one, and we are adding pets to this spring theme. So there is some spring, but there's also a lot of pet activities that you are going to see in my classroom tour.
On our science and exploration table, we will bring in things from outside that we find during our nature walks. These flowers here, we have been watching them fall from a bush, and the children have been very curious about them. They've enjoyed touching them because they're very silky, and they're very curious about what is in the center of the flower. So I brought some inside, and the children can study them, and if they would like to, they can even draw them. One of our art activities this week is going to be making flowers. As I like to do, this will be a two-step process. We are going to use the droppers to drop the liquid watercolors onto the coffee filter so they're nice and vibrant. Then when they dry, the children are going to take one of the colorful doilies and put it in the center of the flower, and then they're going to put some pom-poms in the middle and then create a flower with it. In our block area, we have turned our train table into a little park. We have some pretend grass, and then I have some blue laminated paper that is for the water, and then we have a variety of pets and people, so it can kind of be like a park scene. Also included in our pet theme is washing pets. So we have both bins filled with some water, and then the children can use the small sponges that are inside to wash the animals and then dry them. On our writing table, we will be working on progressing from left to right, and I made these printables, and I will put a link to it in the description. And they simply start on the left, like the first row is the dog, and then they move their marker across the paper to the dog's food bowl. Our dramatic play area is a pet shop. And so I created some labels that you will see here, and I will put a link to these in the description. And they're just labels of different things that you might find in a pet store. And then the children can sort the different stuffed animals and place them in the bins with the appropriate label. On our light table, we have some x-rays of pets, and then I put a little pet figurine on top of it so the children can match them up. And then as for our table activities, one of the activities is called Feed the Dog, and this is by Lakeshore. And the children are going to use the tweezers to pick up the dog bones one by one and transfer them into the dog bowl. Also on our activity table, we have some Melissa and Doug pet puzzles. We have this one here, and we have this one here. I also have this spring counting printable, and I will put a link to in the description. So if you are interested in downloading it, you can, it's free. And I just make two copies, and I cut one of the copies apart so they're little cards, and then they place it on the matching number. And one more table activity that we have are these spring lacing cards, which are a fun fine motor activity. And then for Play-Doh, the children can press down the Play-Doh onto the mat, and then they can press the little small animals on top as part of our pet theme. So this is week one of our spring theme with a pet theme included. Thanks for watching.